All right, I'm back. Shalom. All praises, glory, and honor to Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai by Hashem and Kakodash. Double honors unto the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that rule well through the scriptures. Peace to those we elect. This was a part two in regards to expose him slash her, Margaret Sanger. Phone cut off, you know, slacky about that. But anyway, picking up where we left off, I was reading Exodus 1 and 10, I believe, so I'll grab that again. Exodus 1 and 10. It says, come on, let us deal wisely with them, lest they multiply and it come to pass, that when there falleth out any war, they join also unto our enemies and fight against us, and so get them up out of the land. Therefore they did set over them taskmasters to afflict them with their burdens, and they built to Pharaoh treasure cities, Pithom and Ramses. So that's what the Egyptians did to the Israelites when we were captive over there. They saw us growing. And when you go into that history, Joseph gave us a good portion of land that was suitable for farming and raising our livestock, you know, because we were shepherd people, you know, goats and sheep and things like that, you know. And so we was, and then we were multiplying, you know, the Lord gave us the blessing of being fruitful. So, you know, we got multiple wives, we multiplying, we got the law. So we doing each other good and the Lord blessing us. And they saw that, the Egyptians, and they said, look, we got to deal wisely with them. We got to put them in captivity. And like I mentioned in the previous video, with the so-called white man coming in that same stead of dealing wisely with us. Now let's look up that word wisely in the Hebrew real quick. And it's chakam. Chakam. And it means to be or become wise. Alright. Wisdom. Let's go to judge, hence to rule. To make wise, to teach wisdom. And so, like, the way that they dismantle and destroy our people is rooted in dark wisdom, you know? Like, for the Planned Parenthood thing, they use all of these things about feminism and women's rights. But in all actuality, it's to destroy the Israelites. Because the number one cause of death of so-called black people is abortion. It beats heart disease, black-on-black crime, police violence, stroke, heart attack. It beats all of those combined, all right? And then they'll, like I said, they'll mask it under freedom of choice and pro-choice or, you know, whatever they want to mask it on. But that's them dealing wisely, all right, with these various philosophies and doctrines that they get us to take hold on to, which is effectively to destroy us. Now, when you there's something called the Jezreel schedule. I'm gonna read some about it. Basically, the Jezreel schedule is this this blueprint on how to judge intelligence from babies and toddlers, right? So let me read a little bit from it. I know I Googled it. I'll just Google it again. 1 second. All right. The Jezreel developmental schedules are a set of developmental metrics which outline the ages and stages of development in young children developed by Dr. Arnold Jezreel and colleagues. The original scale is generally considered not to satisfy the standards of rigor currently accepted in the field of psychometrics, and is no longer used as an evaluative rubric in the clinical context. So basically, what that's saying is that they don't use it anymore, and it's not valid anymore. And at one point in time, it was valid. But the reason why they made it, did away with it, so to speak, was why? Because the so-called Negro children were outperforming the so-called white children within that scale. All right, because they judge intelligence based off how early a child walks. Matter of fact, we'll get some of them. Okay. It says, when the infant first rolls from back to stomach unassisted, when the child first utters words, when the child learns to walk, all right? And then further things would be like when the child smiles. So everything that they set on that scale, which determined the intelligence factor, they concluded that the so-called Negro babies were about 6 months advanced ahead of the so-called white babies. That's why when you go back to the quote that Margaret Sanger said that I originally brought up, she said what? Colored people's genes are too strong. We must find ways to exterminate and confuse them so that we stay in power or we are doomed. Right. And that's them dealing wisely. Those ways to confuse and destroy us. All right. Poisoning the air, the food, the soil. All right. Everything that the so-called Negroes got access to is always inferior. The education system is always inferior to what the so-called white people got access to, because they know that if it's an actual equal playing field, then they will be overtaken, and basically the world will realize that we're better rulers, you know? We're more suited to rule the earth than these people, you know? Than any heathen, whether it's the Chinese, they eating turd burgers. They separating enzymes from feces, making food out of it. So them too, you know? But anyway, Lord willing, I'll remember to put this debate in the description box, which it speaks about. There was a debate between William Shockley and Frances Cress Wilson, the so-called black woman with the PhD in psychology and medicine. And she debated this guy in the 70s, and he was a proponent of so-called black people being inferior to the so-called white race. And during their debate, she brought up these various things like the Giselle schedule and certain little facts of information that even he had to agree with. And that debate, and they spoke of it in the interview, it effectively ended his career, you know? Because she totally dismantled all his points, you know? Like, effortlessly and beautifully, you know? But ultimately, it all goes back to the scripture. One people shall be stronger than the other, you know, in all assets of strength, physical, mental, you know, spiritual, all of it. But this is what I'm going to grab. Habakkuk. This is the book of Habakkuk. 1 second. I had it earlier, but I lost it. Let me see. This is Habakkuk 2 and 15. It says, woe unto him that giveth his neighbor drink, that puttest thy bottle to him, and makest him drunken also, that thou mayest look on their nakedness. Right, so when you get people drunk, when people are drunk or under the influence of alcohol, they're more easily susceptible to what you're trying to get them to do. All right? And that's a metaphor for Esau's philosophies. All right? And his thought processes. He get our people drunk off his viewpoint, and it makes us more pliable to do what he wants us to do. All right, like the Planned Parenthood thing, it was hidden behind women's rights and pro-choice and pro-life. All right, but the end goal was what? To destroy your people. All right, even when you look at the mission statement of the Black Lives Matter movement, it says basically to destroy the patriarchy and forward so-called black trans rights. All right, so on the outskirts, it seemed benevolent. Oh, Black Lives Matter, but the ultimate goal is what? To destroy you, as a to destroy your people. You know, divide and conquer. So that's putting wine to your neighbor, getting them to drink. You know, liquor make you more susceptible. All right, and those philosophies make us more susceptible when, you know, when our people take hold to him. But it says, woe unto him that giveth his neighbor drink, that puttest thy bottle to him, and makest him drunken also, that thou mayest look on their nakedness. Because when you're naked, you're in a shameful position. And, you know, our people, we're in a shameful position. A lot of us doing drugs, selling drugs, killing, murdering. And ultimately, all these things separate you from knowing you're an Israelite and knowing that the God of the Bible is your God. And his true name is Yahweh. And his son name, whom they call Jesus, ignorantly, his name is Yahweh Shai. That's the ultimate form of naked, all right? But, you know, our people that's Muslims, you're naked. You know, Christians, you're naked. So it's various degrees of it. And Esau got various different, the so-called white man, he got various different philosophies and doctrines for you to fall into, all right? As long as it keep you away from this truth, this knowledge. But the scripture says, woe unto him, all right, that devised these plans to keep people hidden from the truth, from the knowledge, all right? It says, verse 16, thou art filled with shame for glory, because they used to glory in these things, but now it's shameful for them. See, they done tore down the statue of Margaret Sanger somewhere. Let me look it up real quick. They recently just tore her let me see, Margaret Sanger. She was basically removed from something. She lived from 79 to 66. Let me see. I'm gonna type in Margaret Sanger removed from. Why Planned Parenthood is removing founder Margaret Sanger from its Manhattan, from a New York, her name from a clinic, right? Because it's, she's filled with America, aka Babylon, is filled with shame for glory. Everything that they gloried in, we're coming to find out that it was begotten or executed upon very, very shameful tactics, you know? It says, drink thou also and let thy foreskin be uncovered. All right, so let you be exposed. Let you be naked, all right? Let you be ashamed. You know, when you be naked, you watch the cartoons or the TV shows, somebody naked, they hurry up and cover themselves because they're embarrassed and ashamed. Now they're embarrassed, all right, because of their riches gotten by deceit, all right? That position of authority and stature that they got, the means that they went about it is shameful now. And videos like the one I'm doing and other brothers doing and various people doing that's exposing it, like I quoted in previously, Jeremiah 49 and 10, I have made Esau bear it. He is not able to hide himself. All right? Matter of fact, we can grab that real quick and then segue back. Jeremiah 49 and 10, but I have made Esau bare, or another word for bare is naked, exposed. I have uncovered his secret places. Yeah, a lot of things that you've done in secret, you've done in the dark, all right, it's getting exposed, all right, and your true motive. See, you've hidden your motive with niceties and smooth words, but now your true motive is coming out, all right. It says, I have uncovered his secret places, and he shall not be able to hide himself. Right. So you can't hurry up and do some PR and, you know, make an apology or make a little donation and everybody forget and it'll blow over. No. These things are being they're being doubled down on, right? That's one of the new buzzwords, double down. Yeah, we doubling down on you. We honing it in.